Good evening. Good evening. How was your day?
Good evening, miss. It was great.
Good. And how was your weekend?
Very cold.
Well, my weekend was somehow strange because I was waiting for some information from people from a thesis. They were supposed to want the thesis for 2 weeks ago, and then I checked the things, they just contact me, but I check what they already have, and they already don't have anything good. It is not even, for me, it is not even like any homework from a seventh grader. It's awful. And this, I am the third person that they contact to help them to make the thesis. And I say, but this is not a thesis. And they are not using all the things that they have to use in a Word document, because in a Word document you can put the index and you can put the textual references, and after you put that, the bibliography comes by itself. You don't need to type anything because you already put them in the reference.
By in Spanish or in English? No.
In Spanish.
Ah, yeah.
Yes, but I can do both English and Spanish. The structure for a document is the same.
Oh, yeah.
Either or. But it is a thesis for a psychologist.
Oh, yeah.
I have made thesis for engineering, for a different
thesis,
different no professions, because I'm good on that. All the person that I have helped with the thesis have passed. They are already graduated. So I am good on that. In sometimes there were people that have a lot of problems.
And, yeah. And 3 years, and
when they come to me, they are almost at the end of the time to give all that they need, and in less than 2 weeks, I made the whole thesis for them. And sometimes I have to gather the information, because today's work, I had to gather all the information. Well, I even changed the topic, because I told them what you want to do with this thesis, according how you are focusing it. You won't have access to clinical files, because that is something that not a clinic, not a doctor will share that for you. No. Even when you get your own clinic, you don't have to share your patients' information with anybody.
Oh yeah.
Mm-hmm. Something very restricted. Wow. Now, this is the 13th class, and this week will be the last one for us. I hope that you already have finished the platform, and if you want, don't worry, we will finish, but you have to work with us, okay, to finish this. There was somebody that told me that has problem with the platform. Have you meant it?
Se lo todavía no está para descargar el certificado.
I don't know because I don't work with the platform. O sea, no, yo no puedo, yo no tengo acceso a eso. Es más, creo que ni la gente de inglés corporativo tiene acceso a la plataforma en sí, porque si no ya lo hubieran soltado. Es alguien, creo que es en México que se las están haciendo la plataforma.
Sí, porque yo no lo pude descargar todavía.
Ajá. Entonces, pero ya para ahorita ya debería de estar disponible.
Sí, porque todavía ahora probé y nada.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Pero no se preocupe porque de esta semana no puede pasar. De esta semana no puede pasar, porque tiene que poder usted bajar su ¿cómo se llama? Su certificado, y por favor revisen que tenga su nombre correcto y que tenga la fecha correcta. ¿Okay? Revisen, porque algunas veces hay problemitas ahí. Todo, o sea, acuérdense que aún una letra, o sea, si a usted le ponen Carla con C, no es la misma Carla, ¿verdad? O sea, usted tiene que cerciorarse que se lo pongan como está en su documento personal. ¿Ok? Now, let's see. We will... this man, he was a thing, okay? But sometimes he say very important things. To improve is to change. To be perfect is to change often. Winston Churchill. Okay. To improve is to change. And to be perfect is to change often. That means you have to be improving yourself often. Frequently, okay, and that's what you are doing while you are studying, because education is a way to improve yourself. Okay, now remember that we were with the spelling rules for the present participle. Okay, we call this present participle ing form or gerund. And those three ways we can call the same thing. Most verbs just add ing. Example, repeat. Work working.
Work working.
Buy buying.
Buy buying.
Verbs ending in e, remove the e and add ing. Take taking.
Take taking.
Write writing.
Write writing.
Verbs ending in one vowel followed by one consonant. Double the the last consonant and add ing. Get getting.
Get getting.
Run running.
Run running.
Run running.
Not die dying.
Lying,
lying, lying,
lying, lying,
lying, lying, lying, lying.
If you notice it here, there is a change because they finish with an E, but they don't just remove the E and then ing, because we do so, we have two I's side by side. So they change the I for Y and then add ing. Okay. Okay. Sorry, I muted you all because somebody has very, very strong the volume of the television. Now. Present continuous use. We use the present continuous to talk about things happening now and to describe an action in progress. Now, repeat. We use present continuous.
We use the present continuous.
Continue.
To talk about things happening now.
To talk about things happening now. Happening now.
To describe an action in progress.
To describe an action in progress.
Where's John?
Where's John?
In his room.
In his room.
He's doing his homework.
He's doing his homework.
You're speaking too fast for me.
You're speaking too fast for me.
Those are things that are happening right now, okay? Now. Temporary activities.
Temporary
activities. Disculpen, el que tiene el televisor alto, por favor, se pone en mute. Thank you. Now, present continuous. We use also present continuous for temporary activities to describe. To describe a short term or temporary situation. Okay, now repeat. Temporary activities.
Temporary activities.
To describe a short term or temporary situation.
To describe a short term or temporary situation.
We are learning about trees this week. My brother is staying with friends in London. Until he finds somewhere to live. If you notice, this is a short term or a temporary situation, okay? But we use present continuous to talk about that. Now, situations of change.
Situations of change.
For example, the hole in the ozone layer is getting bigger. It's something that is changing, okay? The hole in the ozone layer.
The hole in the ozone layer
is getting bigger.
It's getting bigger.
The number of pupils in the school.
The number of pupils in the school is falling.
Pupils is the same as saying students. Okay. Pupils is the same as saying students. Future arrangements.
Future arrangements.
We are flying to Spain.
We are flying to Spain.
On a school trip next month.
On a school trip next month.
I'm seeing the head teacher after class.
I'm seeing the head teacher after class.
I think
the teacher after class.
Present continuous or present simple?
Present continuous, present simple.
Okay, here we have this, the first one is present simple. And we are talking about habitual situation. And something that is happening now is used the present continuous. When we are talking about something that is always true, we use the simple present. When we are talking about currently thing, or sea, something that is happening right now, we use present continuous. And wait. Chick speaks French and German. Chicken speak these languages. Okay, she speak. Then it is used in simple present. Okay, because it's something that she knows and use. Okay, is something she already knows. Well, and here now, she's speaking to someone on her mobile. She's speaking at the moment, okay? Now, repeat after me. It rains a lot in Scotland.
It rains a lot.
It's raining in
Scotland.
Okay. Put on an anorak.
Put on an anorak.
It's raining now.
It's raining now.
Scientists do experiments.
Scientists do experiments.
To test their theories. That is something that is always true. All the scientists have theories, and they have to perform experiments to test those theories, okay? Now, scientists are doing experiments.
Scientists are doing experiments.
To see if there is life on Mars. This is something that is currently... doing, okay? They always do experiments, but right now they are doing that specific type of experiments, okay? Now, she speaks French and German. This is in simple present because it's something that she already knows, okay? It's part of her, okay? She speaks French and German.
Wait a minute.
She's speaking to someone on her mobile. Okay, that is something that is happening now. Now, we have here the affirmative, negative, and interrogative way. If you notice, we have the auxiliary since the affirmative form, different than the simple present. When we use in the affirmative, we don't use the auxiliary. We use the auxiliary only for negative and for interrogative. That's a difference. Then what is another difference? That we have the verb to be as an auxiliary and not as a main verb, okay? And another difference? Well, just that, in a structure, just that. And Now, repeat after me. I am arriving at 2.
I am arriving at 2.
I am arriving at
2. I am not arriving at 2.
I am not arriving
at 2. I am not arriving at 2.
Am I arriving at 2?
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 You are calling home.
You are calling home.
You are not calling home.
You are not calling home.
Are you calling home?
You are not calling home.
Are you calling home?
Are you calling home?
He is going to the movies.
Is he going to the movie?
She is helping the teacher.
She is not helping the teacher.
Is he helping the teacher? We are stopping the taxi. You are washing the jeans. You are not watching the jeans. Are you watching the jeans? They are opening the door. They aren't opening the door.
Are they opening the door?
Well, another thing is that since we have the auxiliary from the affirmative form, the main verb remains the same for affirmative, negative, and interrogative. Okay, if you notice, the main verb is arriving in the first place, but you have the same arriving for affirmative, negative, and interrogative, okay? Any questions about the structure of present continuous forms?
No, miss.
No? Okay. Now, there is an exception. Okay, there are some verbs that we never use in the present continuous tense because they are states and cannot have a progressive form. These verbs are preference or state verbs, such as know, have, for possession, like, love, prefer, hate, want, believe, own, cause. For this and similar verbs, we use the simple tenses, okay? That means that these verbs cannot be used as present progressive. These verbs are always used in simple present tense when you are referring to a present situation or something that is happening right now and all that, okay? The present continues for the future, okay? Repeat, when we talk about fixed event in the future.
We often use the present continuous.
It's particularly common.
It's particularly common.
When you refer to appointments in your agenda.
When you refer to appointments in your agenda.
For example.
For example.
I'm going to the dentist on Tuesday at 10 a.m.
I'm going to the dentist on Tuesday at 10 a.m.
But if you notice, this is for future arrangements, but I already have the date, okay? I already have the appointment with the dentist, but I will develop it later on, but I am using the present continuous, okay? We are meeting my sister for lunch today.
We are meeting for sister.
My sister for lunch today.
Okay. He's having a haircut this afternoon.
He's having a haircut this afternoon.
What time are you leaving?
Are you leaving?
They're taking the seven o'clock train.
Okay.
Any doubts? Sorry. Simple present or present continuous? We had to choose when we use the present continuous and when we use the simple present, okay? When you are not sure whether to use the present simple or the present continuous, ask yourself these questions. O sea, cuando usted no sepa si está la oración, si la oración debe ir en presente simple o en presente continuo, debe de contestarse estas preguntas. Is it a long-term situation?
Is it a long-term situation?
If so, use present simple. Is it a state verb? If so, use the present simple. Okay, do you understand this?
No.
No?
The simple present, they use the simple present for both.
Yes.
In the first and the second.
In these ones, both are simple present.
Long term and state verb.
Yes. Yes.
For example, long
term. Remember that we have here the state verbs. Okay. The state verbs are like, love, prefer, hate, want, believe, own, and coast. I suggest you to.
You can say wanting, miss. Wanting? No.
Not as a present continuous, because sometimes we have the ing thing, but it's not for a present continuous. Statement. Okay? It's not within the structure and for that meaning. Okay? Remember that when it's a state verb, you cannot use it as a verb. Remember that sometimes you put ing in some verbs, but to make them a noun or to make them something else, okay? It's not a verb, okay?
No. Okay.
Now, when you are not sure whether to use the present simple or the present continuous, ask yourself this question. Is it an action verb happening in this moment? If so, use the present continuous.
Yeah.
Now, is it an action verb that is a temp that is a temporary situation. If so, use the present continuous. Okay. Now, is it a fixed plan in the future? If so, use the present continuous. Okay. Now you have to ask yourself, it is happening in the in this moment. The verb is a temporary situation, or if it's a fixed plan in the future, okay? You have to be sure of that. Note, as you can see, we use these two tenses in many daily situations. So that means that present simple and present continuous are the most useful or used tenses in the language. Okay, they're really useful to learn as well as you can. Try to practice them a lot until they become natural. And pay special attention to the third person singular form because it will really make a difference in your accuracy in conversation, okay? That means that you have to use the words properly, okay? Any questions so far? This is not in the platform, okay? Now, we have this form. I will send it through WhatsApp. And as the last time, do it and try to do your best, okay? Have you received it?
Yes, miss.
Okay. Then go ahead. Do you want me to help you? I'm looking for it. Okay. Now we have the present simple versus present continuous. You have to decide when you are going to use the simple present and when you are going to use the present continuous. For example, on Fridays, we usually, it is finish or are finishing.
Early. Are finishing. Are finishing. Finishing.
No. Finish? Because it says that usually.
Usually.
Then it's a habit.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. It's something that always happens. Then we use simple present.
Yeah, simple present.
Uh-huh. Now, number two. Today, we late because of a meeting.
Today is finished.
We are finishing.
We are finishing.
We are finishing.
Estamos terminando tarde, okay.
Estamos terminando tarde por una reunión.
She comes.
Okay, now. My best friend is called Daniel. She
comes.
She comes from France because it's where she was born. Okay. She comes from France.
Daniel is coming to visit me today. He's coming.
Coming.
Daniel is coming.
Yes, Daniel is coming to visit me today because this is a temporary situation. They have a warehouse outside the city.
They have.
They have. Because it's something that is a long term. Okay. They have a warehouse outside.
They have.
They have.
They
have a break.
They
are
having
a break.
They're having a break.
Están teniendo en ese momento. Yes.
Ajá. Es algo que está sucediendo en el momento.
Sí, my boyfriend and I. Go to a concert.
This evening, my boyfriend and I go to a concert.
To a concert.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, miss. No. Go.
Permítame.
I'm going? No.
This evening, en esta tarde.
Uy.
Estamos yendo. We're going.
Mm-hmm.
This evening, my boyfriend and
I go out.
Pero para go. I no va a usar are. Uh-huh. No va a usar are. Para
permítame, permítame.
Exception.
Tengo que poner algo aquí. Okay. La compañera no le descarga en WhatsApp. Lo que pasa es que ha de ser que tiene lento el internet. Pero ya se lo mandé aquí. Okay. Vaya que revisa.
Yeah, a mí me carga en HTML. Bien. Desconfigurado, lo voy a descargar después.
Ah, de verdad.
Yo creo que es la velocidad del internet.
A lo mejor. Sí, porque es algo que está en un drive.
Es doc.google.com. Docs.
Sí.
En la nube está, ajá.
Ajá. Es de un drive.
Yo porque lo tengo instalado aquí. La nube.
Ajá. Okay. Now, ya hay dos que ya lo respondieron.
Le preguntaba a Miss, this evening my boyfriend and I go.
Are going. Porque es this evening, es a temporary situation.
Pero si dice,
are going. Es apóstrofe.
Are going.
Uh-huh. O sea, porque es my boyfriend and I.
Ah, es plural, plural. Plural. Are going. Oh,
es,
yeah.
Es como we.
We, yes.
Ajá, uh-huh. We are going. Esas son las cascaritas.
Fallé.
Okay, now I normally
normalmente go out with my
go
friends.
Out. Está en presente simple porque es normally, o sea, es algo que sucede siempre.
Okay.
Entonces, vaya. I
I am taking a shower when I get back home.
Yeah. No, I take a shower.
I take.
Mm-hmm. Oh, sí. I take.
Porque es algo que estoy haciendo siempre. Más en pandemia.
Aunque no lo está haciendo en ese momento, sino que lo hace siempre.
Ajá, siempre. Es habitual.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. We are making a quiz in this moment. At this moment, you are.
It's really.
Yes, you are currently. Hey.
Así voy a tener bien.
No, y no, así hacemos siempre todos los checkpoints, siempre entre todos. Vaya, vamos a ver cómo van las estadísticas. Alguien se equivocó en pusieron they are having, y es they have. Acuérdense que se pone en presente continuo cuando es temporary situation. Pero esto es algo que ellos ahí la tienen. ¿Sí? Aquí sí era are having. They are having a break. My boyfriend and I are going, porque es algo que es temporary. Todo esto sí es temporary. Okay. Well, you are doing well. Any questions about the things that we have just seen? Algo que no les haya quedado muy... Acuérdense que esto, a pesar de que sí es algo que se mencionó en la plataforma, no lo han tenido desarrollado en la plataforma. O sea, yo se los he desarrollado porque, o sea, hay ciertos temas que hay que profundizarlos, ¿verdad? Entonces, además que me gusta investigar y dar clases. Entonces, ¿pero alguna duda o consulta?
No, hay que prestar bastante atención en lo que está haciendo, lo que se está diciendo.
Lo que pasa es que aquí está. Estas son las cosas importantes. ¿Cuándo es que vamos a utilizarlo? ¿Cuándo vamos a ocupar el presente continuo? ¿Y cuándo vamos a utilizar el presente simple? Entonces, si son long-term situation y si son state verbs, ocupamos el presente simple. Si son cosas que están pasando en el momento, si son cosas temporales y si son planes a futuro, ocupamos el presente continuo. Estas tres son las más importantes porque estas son las notas o las excepciones, ¿no? Estas tres que están aquí son a los que les tienen que dar como más importancia. De el 11, 12 y 3 es al que le tienen que dar más importancia para dominar bien lo que es el tema. Y sí, ¿verdad? O sea, todo lo demás lo deben de estudiar, ¿verdad? Porque esto es algo que lo acabamos de ver. Entonces, pero acuérdense que este material yo se lo hago llegar por medio de WhatsApp. Y usted lo tiene ahí como para seguirlo estudiando. Más ahorita se lo voy a mandar. A alguien que no le llegue el PPT porque tiene problemas con el WhatsApp, me escribe y me manda su correo para mandárselo por correo. ¿Verdad?
Cuando son adverbios de frecuencia, Miss, usually often, por lo general, ahí no se usa ING, ¿verdad?
No, porque son habitual. Cuando usted está haciendo usually, es algo que usted lo está haciendo habitualmente. Entonces es un hábito. Often es otro hábito. ¿Verdad? Entonces ahí se ocupa presente simple.
Yes. Uh-huh. Ay, ¿verdad, Miss? Que aquí en la clase 13, solo la 13 está o la 12 también no.
Este, hay parte de lo de la 12.
Ajá.
Porque ya. tenía que como agarrar parte de lo de la 12. Porque de ahí continuaba. O sea, esto que estamos viendo ahorita es una continuación de lo de la 12. Pero sí, la 12 ya se las pasé también.
Sí, sí, sí. Pero es que me recuerdo que algo que ya habíamos visto está en la 13, entonces.
Sí, es que siempre me gusta como dar un...
retomar.
Como un warm up de lo que ya vimos para continuar.
Yes.
Además de que nos iba a servir porque este...
Sí,
por ejemplo, esto de los spelling rules, esto es importante que lo sepamos. Es más, ahorita todavía tenemos tiempo. Este, saquen sus verbos y vamos a utilizar estas spelling rules en los verbos que ustedes tienen, en la lista de verbos. ¿Verdad? Como hicimos con el presente simple para tercera persona de singular. Vamos a ver.
Regular verb list.
No sé cuál quieren, ustedes escojan.
Ah, porque están en diferentes archivos.
Sí, ¿cuál quieren? Para abrírselos ahorita.
Irregular,
ok. Vamos a ver. Aquí está. ¿Lo alcanzan a ver? Sí. Ok. Vamos a ver. Permítame, le voy a dar. Uy.
Así no, mis.
Se dio vuelta. Bueno. Ya, hoy sí. Como están casi a la par. Vaya, ahí, ¿sí mira bien?
Yeah.
Vaya, en el caso de B, en este caso sí se puede hacer con ING. Entonces, solo que este no pierde la E.
Bien.
Sino que a la E se le agrega ING.
Being.
Being. I am being. Eso sí se puede decir. Estoy siendo. I am being.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Después, I am becoming. O sea, aquí sí pierde la E y solo se le agrega ING.
Becoming.
Sí. En el caso de beginning, se le agrega ING.
Beginning.
Y se le agrega, se repite la N, creo. Es de las que terminan consonante, vocal, entonces se duplica la última consonante y se le agrega ING.
Beginning
con doble N.
Breaking,
solo se le agrega ING. Y aquí en bringing. Va bringing, o sea, lleva dos veces ING. Bringing.
Igual que begin.
Similar, porque en el caso de begin es G-I-N. En cambio, y se acuérdese que se le va a duplicar la N.
Se le duplica.
Ajá, en el cambio este, bringing, no se duplica porque no lleva una vocal antes de la G. Sino que solo se le agrega ING, ING. O sea, bring por sí mismo no está en gerundio, ajá, aunque termine en ing. Sí. Entonces, para hacer los gerundios se agrega ing.
Like building.
Bringing. Uh-huh. Y después, building.
Building.
Uh-huh. Buying. Catching. Choosing. Aquí sí, se le quita la E y se le agrega ING. Uh-huh. Coming. Se le quita la E y se le agrega ING. En este uh-huh caso, cutting se duplica la T.
Doble T, así.
Sí, cutting. Doble T. Cutting. Doing, ING. Solo se le agrega ING. Drinking, se le agrega ING. Driving, se le agrega ING, se quita la E.
Driving. Eating.
No se duplica porque no va una consonante antes de la A.
Miss, eating and eating, ¿se puede decir así? O porque cuando hay
vocal, es lo mismo. Vocal. Es lo mismo, eating, eating. Es lo mismo. Yeah. Lo que pasa es que eating es como British. Eating es este, norteamericano. Los norteamericanos casi siempre a las T las pronuncian como eres.
Eres.
Ajá. Feel feeling. Fight fighting. Finding. Fly flying. Mm-hmm. Forgetting, okay, con doble T.
Ajá.
Acuérdese que cuando termina consonante, vocal, consonante.
Consonante, vocal,
consonante. La última
consonante duplica.
Se duplica, así es. Forgiving, quitándole la E.
Forgiving.
Ajá. Y aquí tenemos get. Es consonante, vocal, consonante, doble T, ING. Give termina en E, se le quita la E y se le agrega ING.
Give.
El caso de going.
Going.
Uh-huh. Have.
Have.
Acuérdense que este como que es state. Ay. Es state verb. Vámonos a la regla. Vamos a ver. Vamos a ver.
Yo lo escribí. Dice no have yet. Like, love, prefer, want, believe, own, sí, cost, sí, have.
Like, love, prefer, hate, want, believe, own, cost. Ah, pues no. Have, sí. Se...
Sí, es el segundo. No,
ah, sí, es el segundo. No, have. Entonces, have. ¿Verdad?
Entonces, ¿no se dice having?
Para, o sea, ¿cómo explicarle? Algunas veces se ocupa having, pero no como presente continuo.
¿Está teniendo una fiesta?
No. I have
party.
A party. Ajá. Uh-huh. Or I am in a party. Estoy uh-huh en una fiesta.
¿Y cuándo es que se usa y que no es continuo?
Este, es que yo ya he visto.
Yo también having, ya lo he visto, pero no
ya sé. Lo he visto, el having. Pero no, o sea, no es dando a entender que es un
presente. Está sucediendo algo, ¿no?
Ajá. Uh-huh.
Bueno, me quedé
tarea. Esa es la diferencia. Ajá. Porque este, ¿cómo se llama? Son de las curiosidades del idioma, ¿verdad? Acuérdese que algunas veces también hay gente que lo utiliza, pero es como en slang English.
¿Slang?
O sea, así como nosotros que hablamos este...
Cosas que no se deben y lo hacemos.
Exacto. El caliche.
Como el caliche, exacto. El street language que le llaman.
El nativo o algo.
No, el street language es el
calle.
De la calle, ajá. Uh-huh. Entonces que la gente habla como quiere. Por ejemplo, cuando la gente en slang English dice I wanna. Entonces, bueno, eso no es gramáticamente correcto.
Sí se puede decir, pero no se escribe.
Lo puede decir, pero, o sea, ya se sabe que es como coloquial, ¿verdad? Pero ya a la hora de ustedes hacer un trabajo que va a presentar, qué sé yo, para una tesis, no puede poner a iguana, ¿verdad? ¿Cuánto? Porque no es gramáticamente correcto. Bueno, entonces vaya, vamos con el otro. Hearing. Hard-hitting. En inglés sería hearing, en norteamericano. Hearing. Keep-hipping.
Keeping.
Growing.
Grow.
Uh-huh. Y el no, que no es, ¿verdad? Deberíamos detachar los verbos que ahorita se los vuelvo a decir.
Los verbos stable.
Los stable son know, have,
come,
like,
have.
Ay, fíjense que aquí hace la aclaración. Have for possession. O sea que have for possession no puede ser having. Pero si va a usar have, que no es para posesión, sí lo puede decir. ¿Verdad? O sea, cuando el verbo no significa posesión, entonces sí puede decir having. ¿Verdad? Vale, entonces ahora, like, love, prefer, hate,
no.
Prefer, hate,
hate,
want, believe,
want,
own, y cost. Todos esos tachen los que eso no se pueden hacer en ing.
Ya. Yeah.
Own.
Cost.
In. Cost.
Okay. Vamos.
Cost.
Pero sí que ya no me pudo abrir, pero vale. Entonces vamos con learning, que solo se le agrega ing. El live se le quita la e, ing.
Lending.
Uh-huh. Letting, este con doble T.
Se lo explica porque es monosílabo o algo así, ¿no?
No, porque va consonante, vocal, consonante.
Consonante, ah, ok.
Ajá. Doble T.
Losing.
Se le quita la E. Making. También en make se le quita la E y se le agrega ing.
Meaning,
uh-huh. Meeting, paying, y aquí se duplica la T, putting,
paying,
reading, running, se duplica la N, saying, en el caso de sí, se le agrega ing al sí, seeing,
sí.
No se le quita la E.
Se dejan las dos. Sí.
Y se le agrega ing. Self-selling. Este sing, igual que el bring, se le agrega ing también, entonces es singing.
Singing.
Sit, se duplica la T. Sitting.
Ajá.
Sleep, sleeping.
Sleeping.
Speak, speaking.
Speaking.
Spend, spending.
Spending.
Stand, standing.
Stand.
Steal, stealing. Sweep, sweeping. Take, taking. Teach, teaching. Tell, telling. Think, thinking. Type right. Aquí se le quita la E igual que al right. Y se le agrega ING. Y el understand, understanding.
Y solo type means type.
Type, means no, type writing.
Ese es escribir, pero...
Sí, este es escribir a máquina. También type, se le quita la E y se le agrega ING. Sí, pero en este caso es typewrite, que es escribir a máquina. Pero también puede poner solo type y solo le agrega, le quita la E y le agrega ING.
Typewriting.
Typing. Bueno, y ahí ya tenemos los verbos estos irregulares. Si quieren hacer el ejercicio también con los regulares, bien lo pueden hacer ustedes por su cuenta. Tienen cualquier duda o consulta, ahí estamos en el WhatsApp.
Okay.
¿Verdad? See you tomorrow. Mañana terminamos Mañana terminamos lo que es la lección 5 y vamos a ver el principio de lo que es el examen final. Porque mañana mismo tienen que hacer ustedes ya el examen final para que lo revisemos el jueves. ¿Verdad? Es más, si pueden hacer el examen final ya,
miércoles
mejor. ¿Verdad? Porque el jueves ya tiene que estar terminado el examen. O sea que el examen el jueves lo vamos solo a revisar que ustedes lo hayan hecho bien. Y acuérdense que tenemos la clase extra que les voy a dar de lo de los possessions y de los, el orden de los adjectives. Y ya nadie me dijo qué más quería que fuera en esa clase extra. ¿Verdad? Pero de todos modos yo les estoy poniendo información extra ya de por sí.
Tenemos suficiente. Vaya, pues. I have enough.
See you tomorrow.
See you, miss. Good night.
Bye bye.
See you tomorrow. Good night.
Bye bye.